stumbled and fell. Though an host should encamp against me, my heart shall not fear. Though war shall rise against me, in this will I be confident. One thing have I desired of the Lord, that will I seek after, that I may dwell in the house of the Lord all the days of my life. To behold the beauty of the Lord and to inquire in his temple. For in the time of trouble, shall hide me in his pavilion, in the secret of his tabernacle shall he hide me. He shall set me up again. Truly know that the Lord is good, and we are thankful that even in this hour that we know that God is still taking care of us. He continues to make a way for us. We've come at this hour to share with this family as they celebrate the life of this our beloved brother and our friend, Brother Terry Allen. Amen. We thank God for this family. We thank God for each of you who are sharing with this family. The family has outlined a program, and we shall use this as our means to conduct this service. We do ask that you will join us now in prayer. Eternal God, our Father, we thank you now for this day. We thank you, God, for your abiding grace and your faith that stays with us, God. We thank you, God, that you keep your hands upon us. And even now, God, we know that you are holding this family. It is our prayer that you will look down upon this family, that you will comfort their hearts and give them strength in this hour, knowing that you are such a merciful God, and we pray that you will have mercy upon them. We ask a special blessing, oh God, upon each of these family members, this mother, these children, oh God, that you will bless them and that you would give them the strength that they need, oh God, as they look to you in the days to come. God, as we come, we want to tell you thank you for Terry and his life. Thankful, oh God, for what he has meant to each of us. We've had the opportunity to know him, and we're so thankful, oh God, that you allowed him to be a part of our lives. We ask that you continue to bless this family. We ask all these blessings now in Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Amen. The family has chosen passages of scripture that they would like for us to share with you at this time. We shall read from John chapter 14, verses 1. Let not your heart be troubled. Ye believe in God, believe also in me. In my Father's house are many mansions. If it were not so, I would have told you. I go to prepare a place for you. And if I go and prepare a place for you, I will come again and receive you unto myself, that where I am, there ye may be also. Amen. The second passage of scripture that they've asked me to share with you comes from the book of Romans. And actually, this passage of scripture will be where we will take our thought for this afternoon as well. From the book of Romans, chapter 14, verse number 8. For whether we live unto the Lord. And whether we die unto the Lord. Whether we live therefore or die, we are the Lord's. Verse 9 says, for to this end Christ both died and rose and revived, that he might be Lord both of the dead and of the living. Amen. As just reading that passage of scripture, we want to simply share with you for a few minutes from the thought, the Lord knows it all. The Lord knows it all. As we're here today, and as I look amongst and see family members here and friends, we can all reflect and we can all come up with a Terry story. There was something about Terry that no matter what, everybody sitting out here can tell you something. You have an encounter with Terry that you will never forget. Whether it was he made you laugh, whether he made you upset, whether you just wish that he would leave you alone for a few minutes, everybody has a Terry Allen story. Terry was never going to be a person that was anywhere nearby that he did not make his presence known. Whether you wanted to hear or not, he was still going to make his presence known. But that's who Terry was. And that's who, over the years, we grew to appreciate and to love him for being him. Terry didn't make excuses for trying to be anybody else. He was simply who he was. And if you couldn't take him for who he was, you still had to take him the way he was. Terry was the person that, as I was sharing the other day, back in high school, for those of you who remember our days in high school, if you were not afraid of Terry, you felt like you should be afraid of him anyway. Amen. He talked loud enough and he boasted enough that if he could talk you into being afraid of him. But at the same time, Terry possessed something that I think few people have. They have it, but they have it in degrees. Terry was just who he was, and he was real about the things that he was real about. If you did not want to hear the truth, don't ask him. If you did not want to know what he thought about it, don't ask him. Because once you asked him, he was going to give you the answer, and if the answer was not what you wanted, you still had the answer. And as we read the scripture today, that helps us to understand that the Lord knows all about all of us. He knows everything there is to know about us. He knows who we are. He knows our ups. He knows our downs. He knows the good. He knows the bad. And in spite of all of those things about us, the Lord still loves us. He loves us in spite of how we treat one another sometimes. He loves us in spite of how we go against his word and against his will, but he still loves us. He loves us so much that, as the scripture said, that he is, whether we live or die, he loves us. He loves us to the point that he sees us in our weakest moments. As a family, you sit here today, and this is a weak time for you because you're dealing with the loss of a loved one, but I want you to understand that the Lord still knows. He knows just what you're feeling. He knows how you feel. And he is able to take care of you even now. The same God that took care of Terry is taking care of you right now. The same God that took care of Terry and set him free from the pain and what he was living in is taking care of you right now. So if he can take care of you now, don't you know he can still be taking care of you down the road? He can still be there with you. He can still comfort you. And whatever the void is that you have in your life right now, whether it be missing a son, whether it be missing a father, a grandfather, a brother, he is able to fill the void for you. He's that voice that you hear in the midnight hour that tells you that everything is going to be all right when you wonder how you're going to make it. He is that voice that when you wake up in the morning, you wonder, how am I going to make it through this day? He is that voice that tells you, I'm here with you. That I'll never leave you, nor will I forsake you. He knows all. He knows all because he died for us. He died that he would have, that we would have the right. And because of that, he knew that we would be weak. He knew that we would mess up along the way. But he still says, I'm still your God. He still lets you know that even though you mess up sometimes, you can still turn around and come back. He lets you know that I'm giving you another chance. Every day that you wake up, I'm giving you another chance to correct. I'm giving you another chance. I'm not holding that against you. I'm letting you know that I was your God yesterday when you walked away, and I'm still your God today. No matter how many times we leave and come back, he is still right there. Same God. Same God. Same God that was right there when Terry took his last breath. That's the same God that's holding you right now. That's the same God that's letting you know I still love you. That's the same God that's telling you in your heart and in your mind that everything is going to be all right. We cannot live in this world and have folk that we love and not miss them when they go. But he understands that. He knows that we long to have them near us. He knows that we miss those times when we were growing up and we didn't have a care in the world and we didn't think about that we all had souls that needed to be saved. He knew that the day would come when we would have to call upon the name of the Lord. And I want you to understand, just like Terry had a chance to call upon the name of the Lord, he's given us a chance, right? He's given us a chance to say, don't worry about yesterday. I got yesterday's past and gone. I'm telling you that I'm here for you right now. I'm telling you that I got your tomorrow in my hand. I'm telling you to trust in me, even though you're dealing with the loss of a son, a father, a brother. I'm letting you know I'm still here with you. That's the kind of God we serve. He's the God of the living. He's the God of those who need him. He's a God of compassion that he can hold us all at the same time. He can wipe all our tears away at the same time. He can restore joy in our heart at the same time. He can give us a reason to tell him thank you at the same time. Because he is God and he knows all things. So
So miss and tear, yeah, we're gonna miss it. We're gonna miss some of the stuff you used to say. We're gonna miss some of the stuff you used to do. We're gonna miss him being a clown when we didn't want him to be a clown. We're gonna miss those times when we wish that we had done a little bit more and we didn't do it. We're gonna think about those missed opportunities. But can I tell you that there's still a God who knows? There's a God who knows all about it. There's a God who understands. There's a God who took care of him, is gonna take care of you. There is a God who knows all about us. So if I had one more thing to say to you today, I would tell you to know who he is. If you don't know him for yourself, today would be a good day to get to know him for yourself. I'm not talking about just because everybody can see you. I'm talking about getting to know him in your heart. Get to understand that when you call upon him, he will answer. Get to know that when you need him, he will show up. Get to know that there is nothing that you will go through that he will not walk away and he will be right there with you. He'll hold your hand. He's holding your hand right now. He's rocking you right now. He's keeping you right now. He is in your heart right now, letting you know that everything will be all right. God. He's the kind of God that you can trust in. Can I tell you that wherever you are right now, you ain't got to try to fix yourself up for him. He'll take you just the way you are. All your mess ups, all your breakups, all your upsets, all your downfalls, he will take you just the way you are. Because he's a God who knows. He's the God of the living. He's the God of the dead. So whether we live or whether we die, he is still God. Pray with you, eternal God, our Father, we thank you now for being God in our lives. Towards life. We're thankful, oh God, for allowing him to be teared in our lives. God, we thank you that you gave him a chance, just like you've given us a chance, to get to know you for himself. God, it's our prayer that even in the dying hour, he was able to call upon your name. For we know that you are a God of all things. So God, we thank you and we praise you. We ask these blessings now in Jesus' name we pray. may the grace of God, the sweet communion of the Holy Spirit, rest, rule, and abide with each of us now, henceforth, and forevermore. Together, all the people of God said amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen.